What was your biggest shit, no going back now moment? 1. Stepping off that sandbar I could barely reach to swim out to the girl caught in the riptide, and not knowing how a riptide worked. It took what felt like hours but, spoiler alert, we made it. Too early in the season for lifeguards. I remember calling out to people walking their dogs on the beach but we were so far off they didn't even look towards us. 2. When I was younger, letting my older cousin talk me into a canoe ride down a flooded river. We'd planned it days in advance but there was a lot of heavy rain in the area and the normally calm river was near flood level and quite rough. I really didn't want to do it but I didn't want to let him down either so I still went. I knew as soon as we saw the river this was a terrible idea. The whole thing was a shit show and I honestly thought we were going to die. We had no control and at one point we got stuck nose down in a large rock, knowing if we tipped out we were drowning. We somehow made it out into the shore where we walked back with a canoe. 3. This one is quite literally a not going back moment. As a Boy Scout at summer camp we would always take large group hikes on the last day of camp. This particular camp in West Texas was located in the middle of a deep canyon and cut through with a small stream. The day before our hike day it rained a bit but not too much to make us worry. It was drizzling in the morning when we got up but we were Boy Scouts so that obviously didn't stop us. So our long hike could us cross a small stream up the canyon maybe 10 to 15 times, no problem, and everything went great. After a while we get to a medium-sized pond that we all decided to go swimming in, that was fun and we all had a blast. We get out and dress and we keep going farther up a hill to continue our hike. We get to the top and we hear this wonderfully ominous rushing noise. We look over a ledge and see that the water in the stream was moving a bit faster than we remembered. A friend and I volunteer to go back and see what's happened. A flash flood had ripped through the area we had just left moments before. The water in the pond was at least 7 feet higher than it was 5 minutes before, and it was covered in foam and rapidly overflowing. We decided as a group to test our luck and go back to see if we could get out, but the last stream crossing had turned into a very fast moving river crossing. Needless to say, we were fucked. We literally couldn't go back, and we had to wait a long time to get help and get to the now almost flooded camp. 4. When I was about to get on the plane to my first semester of med school, my dad, never one for sentiment, said well, you're now actually worth more dead than alive, don't screw this up. 5. I hopped a freight train once, and the moment it hits 15 to 20 miles per hour, you're just along for the ride. But the real no going back moment came when the train stopped on a siding outside Winnemucca. After waiting there for like 5 hours, I decided to walk into town and get some ice cream sandwiches. As soon as I got 50 yards from the train, I realized, if it starts rolling now, I'll be too far away to chase it down. I'll just be stuck in this town for a while. Edit, for you kids out there, riding freight trains is dangerous and illegal, and dirty and loud and unreliable. Don't do it. Also, I should point out that Winnemucca is home to some of America's best Basque restaurants, fantastic cowboy heritage sites, and it's the gateway to the Black Rock Desert. It's got something for everyone, not just stranded hobos. 6. First time I went skydiving was a tandem jump and the guy told me on the ground once we get in the door we'll rock back and forth 3 times, on the 3rd time forward just roll out the door. So, me being the trusting sort thought that was a solid plan. We get up to altitude, open the door, I put my feet on the little platform and cross my arms just like he told me to. The fucker rocked back once and pushed us out the door immediately. My only thought was that wasn't the 3. Oh fuck, we're falling. 7. During takeoff on my first ever flight at the age of 30. I have a real intense fear of heights. 8. Walking into a MMA fight and the cage closes behind you. 9. Getting in the ambulance after suffering a grand mal seizure from alcohol withdrawals. When I finally said enough is enough and decided I needed to quit drinking before it killed me, I thought I could detox on my own as I was terrified of hospitals. I was wrong. I spent a week detoxing in the ICU. And now, almost a full year later, I'm still very happily sober and I'm completely thriving. 10. Hiking backcountry snowboarding with a guy. Got stuck in a flat area and needed to hike out in deep powder. It was getting dark and kept coming out of thick trees to 50-foot plus cliff areas. It was getting darker and we didn't have much light left and finally came out to another cliff area with about a 10-foot cliff, 20 feet of landing and then a second 10-foot cliff area that had a narrow landing to an open glade. It was either go for it and don't fall and get hurt, or start making a snow tunnel and get ready to sleep on the mountain for the night at East Vail Chutes in Colorado. We both made it through the cliff jump safely, but it was sketchy. When we got to town, we both had a couple tall whiskeys in the first bar we got to, and I was still shaking. Could have possibly died if we had to stay on the mountain overnight or got seriously hurt, and then died, making the jumps to get to an area we could get down as it was getting dark, but it was either jump or start making a snow shelter. We were definitely not prepared with backcountry gear and got lost in the area, even though we had both ridden it a few times with some experienced people who had taken us down before. Scary and something I will never forget. 11. Canoeing over a waterfall. 12. While motorcycling through Vietnam, it was getting late and I was running low on fuel. Too low to turn back to the previous town. If that wasn't bad enough, my bike rack broke. Luckily, a kind man and his daughter stopped to help. He knew no English outside of, "I can fix," so I followed him. I wore my bags and held the rest in my lap. Entering the town, my jaw dropped. It was complete calamity. The streets were filled with people carrying 2x4s, rocks and bottles. Literally hundreds of people. It was like a war zone, with people smashing scooters and cars on fire, people yelling and fighting. A few individuals were running for their lives with mobs in tail. I can still vividly see one man's face as he looked over his shoulder in dread. There were too many people to drive through, so I had to slow down to a crawl. All I kept thinking was, please don't notice me. Please don't rob me and smash my face in. Please know I'm with this kind man and his daughter. The moment lengthened as a few of the town folk started to notice me. I was scared shitless but produced a warm smile. The smile wasn't returned. The kind man looked back and those who were taking interest in me noticed. Can't help but think it helped. We finally breached the throng of people and pulled down an alleyway to his place. I still didn't feel safe, but I needed gas and my rack fixed. I tried to ask the man why all these people were fighting one another. He just smiled and made the drink gesture. It was during Tet, or the Vietnamese New Year. He fixed my rack, gave me some gas and wouldn't take any money as payment. However, like Christmas, the kids received money, so I gave his daughter a fat wad of cash. With his blessing. About 45 minutes later I arrived safely at my hostel in Ninh Vana. 13. Psychedelics. Particularly DMT, because it all happened so quickly and intensely. 14. Mountain biking with some friends on a new trail, which wasn't even a bike trail. We hiked most of the way up since it was too steep to ride up. Carried our bikes all the way up. Rested at the top for a bit and then rolled over the edge. I remember as my front tire crested and gravity started taking over, I thought, there's no way I'm stopping now, unless a tree stops me. 15. I made a budget yesterday to figure out how much I'd need to move out. If I work 2 more hours than planned at a starter job I've lined up, I could do it easily, with all the optional expenses. That's when it hit me that I'm not in college anymore and I actually could have the money to live independently. 16. When I laid in the bed of my psychiatric hospital's bedroom for the first time. 17. Here, try this hot wing. Took a bite in for the next 18 hours. I could only focus on how this was a crime against humanity. And for those now asking, it was the last dab 30 on a drumstick. It was coated all over. I just ate one big bite. And then I went and shoved my head under a cold shower. Then, it was bed and bathroom for several hours as I threw up most of it, but some got digested. I knew going it that it was gonna be hot. My former roommate was a hot sauce aficionado. He never once handed me a wing that was less than a habanero sauce. The question was, am I about to have ghost, pepper X, Carolina Reaper, habanero, etc. 18. Refusing to serve a customer for the first time ever. It may seem small, but it felt like a big win. I work at a cafe and a woman very rudely asked me for a 16 ounces hot coffee. We don't offer that, we just make pour overs. Yeah, we're an expensive bougie shop. And I tried to kindly explain to her why, but told her I could make her 2 coffees if she likes, as long as I stick with the recipe. She demanded I change the recipe. I said no, I can't. She spotted a 16 ounces cup behind me and asked, what's that? Things were already very tense and I grabbed the cup and explained, this is 16 ounces cup, but it's only for cold brew. It looks similar to TH,